Hey, Hulkster, have you seen her? Who are you talking about, man? I'm talking about the beautiful Ms. Elizabeth. Hey, it's Wrestling Hero Figs. He's looking for her, man. The place you ought to be looking for is WrestlingFigures.com. Discount code here, they're going to save you 10% right here on Elite Series 77. We're doing a dually on Rick Rude and Ms. Elizabeth right here. We got the two legends from the line. Well, three, if you consider Viscera. Of course it is, man. That's Attitude Era, and that's right around the same time that these two over here. Actually, no, this was Golden Era, and then it was Attitude, and then New Generation. And we can talk about that later on, but we do got to discuss right here. We already covered four out of the six right here. We did AJ Styles and Ronda last, so if you missed out, go check it out on the channel. And we also did The Fiend, Bray Wyatt, and Viscera. And if you guys did miss out on the giveaway, it's still going on, dude. It is still alive, and it will not end until Elite Series 78 drops. So go enter, and let's get these babies cracked open, man. I want to see the glorious Hero Fix. That's his son. That is not him. You're thinking of his Spawn, but it was idea during that time, right? He was thinking about it. He says, my son, I know I'll have a kid one day, and when he does, he's also going to have the same options as what the crap is going on with this Roban. Oh, I see. They stapled it to the damn plastic. What is going on? All right, interchangeable hands. We got two close fists right here, and then we got two mic open, and then the ones that are in the figure right here, we got glorious. It's not. All right, biggest concern that I had about this figure when I first saw was kind of what this robe was going to do, because a lot of the figures back in the day, a lot of this like fabric, I'm not sure what type of material or what kind of dye they were using, but anytime you remove the robe, especially if it sat in the packaging for well over, you know, 2 years, it would usually stain the figure. So we're definitely going to take a look at that. Hopefully mine clears out. I will show you the robe before I do take it off right here. We got a solid black, and we got Simply Ravishing, right? Lana, if you were curious where she got that from, right here, my friends. This isn't something that was thought about. No, this was actually derived way back in the young days, and I do want to do a comparison because we have seen two different versions of this man released in the past. One in the Legends line, and two right here later put out. I think it was around Elite Series 40-ish. I know a lot of people were using this right here for a custom Dolph Ziggler, and I actually ended up just ordering the Chase right there, so I do plan on making, because if you guys recall, that one has like the IC Championship. Well, you guys will see the idea, man. So, longer hair, shorter hair, right there. Longer. This is kind of the best comparison, because the mullet difference is there, but this one, it's a lot shorter. This one's a lot puffier. I do like the style and the robe. Obviously, this is the one that he wore, but I do like the brighter red as opposed to the black. I don't know what it is, man, but something about that just brings more ravishing to the actual figure itself. This one has like a puckered up lips. This one has got like a side smirk, and this one, he's got the golden stash right there, man. That is the golden stash. That's what dropped the panties back in the late 80s, early 90s, man. If you don't believe me, go check out Hero Fix Facebook page, and they'll show you Hero Fix. You don't have a Facebook page. Oh, yeah, that's right. All right, let's take off the robe and check out what's up, my friends. Hero Fix, you weren't even from the 80s either. What are you talking about? How would you even know, dude? Well, my uncle, he used to always take me on whatever car ride he went on, dude, and he was sporting that stash, man, and he knew exactly how to execute and pull the moves. Yes, as confirmed. I'm gonna tell you this right now, you guys. There is the robe, man. You guys see that? You do plan on keeping this in package. I mean, I guess it really doesn't matter because you're not gonna see what's underneath, but if you plan on posing him around, maybe some acetone might address that issue, but regardless, you guys, that is a huge drawback, man. I mean, we all like posing our figures different ways. If you're posing them right there, doing a signature pose right there by the entrance stage, yeah, the robe, yes, that's gonna work. But when you're in there, right, you're in there doing DDTs and what the heck you want to do, man, this is gonna be a huge issue. It's all over the left arm. I feel like the left arm got it the worst because you're seeing it up on the bicep as well as on the forearm, but on the left right here, it looks like only on the elbow as well as on the, so about the same amount, you guys. We're getting it really scattered all throughout the arms. Luckily, it didn't hit the chest or back region. We do have his tattoo right there. We got that huge anchor to anchor you down and let you know that you need to feel the heat, man. This is summer. It's the right time. It's the right moment for this figure, matter of fact, right? We actually got the matching packaging. Look at this, you guys. We got all the yellows. Well, actually, the Chase would have been a more ideal, but again, stay tuned. Already ordered. It's already on the come up, so definitely look out for that. For the head scan, I have to say that the likeness, it is very much there, man. I still have yet to figure out how exactly they do what they do with what they've done with a lot of these guys. I mean, it's not like they can say, yo, Ravishing, yeah, what up? Can you come in just for a quick scan, man? We got to do a full 360. No, you can't do that, man. The man ain't around. I mean, if he was, just know that the look and expression, there would be a lot more wrinkles. So, yeah, we'll figure it out one day. And when we do, I'm going to tell you that the torso, we're seeing the same torso that we've seen with the other figures, except this is a lighter one. I
know it's not picking it up right there on camera, but check it out. We're getting a lot darker going on with this, and we're getting more of a, I don't know, like a Dolph Ziggler skin tone is what it is. So shades right there. On this one, I think they share the exact same thing. Yeah, these two are pretty much it. So this is just a slight skin tone right there on this man. And maybe it was like earlier, maybe it was like early summer, and the man just wasn't feeling it that day for the tights. I'm gonna tell you that the tights, you guys, this man was always ravishing with everything that he wore. It didn't matter if it was like a solid bright yellow, or even if it was black, dude, he was gonna bring every color from the freaking rainbow reflected right there on the pants, man. We got a lot of machismo oozing right there towards the bottom. I mean, that's what I pick up, man. I think of the bad guy right there towards the bottom. And then this is kind of like a little bit of Ultimate Warrior, like the mask. This is some that actually comes to mind right there during that time and era. You can kind of see the eyes right there, the war paint seeping down on the left thigh, right, and then we're getting some more flamage going on. Hero Fix, that's not a word. Hey, check it out, man. It's happening. It's going on right here on the knee pads, and then it's all coming together with some yellow towards the boots on the back side. We got Feel the Heat, and we got the fire right there everywhere on this figure. I gotta say, this is a huge plus, man, from like the ones prior. I mean, yes, this one kind of had a lot of paint apps, but at the same time, I feel like this is getting so much more. So I'm gonna tell you this, you guys. We got Simply on the left, and we most def have Ravishing going on with Mr. Rick Rude. I gotta say, I'm giving this a clear 9.5. I'm gonna have to dock a point, man. That freaking coat, like, yeah, it looks sick. Don't get me wrong, the gold looks solid. But if you're going to be doing this to my figgies, man, we're going to have some problems, dude. So we'll give him a 9.5. And I do plan on wrapping up the full series. That's what we've done, man. Ever since Hero Figs started doing the figure reviews, that's something we've kept alive, man. It was from day one and bringing it all the way to Elite Series 77. You got to know, man. Like, if you're just kind of on the fence, like, Hero Figs, should I pick up the full series? Or should I get, you know, maybe just the Fiend? Because that's the main piece right there that people are asking for. That's why you have to rank, man. A set is not a set unless you know how to determine. And this is why you clicked on the video. And maybe if you are stopping to the channel for the first time, maybe you'll know that all these figgies right here, we get interchangeable hands on all of them. We got the open hand mics right there on this one, and then we got what would you call this? Yeah, it's just a simple blend. It's not like a full-on open hand like what we saw right here, but I mean, it kind of has like a slight curve. You guys can see it, man. We actually saw it in the previous figures that we did see for her. Actually, this one had a fist, and then the other one had the open hand that you're seeing on both of these figures right there. So this is actually a custom. This is something that I want at some point. Like, if they do plan on releasing her just one more time, give me the NWO attire. I think that'd be sick, man. I ended up using my Walmart exclusive, so technically we can definitely still use this as a prime example, because this was based off the Walmart line. And then this one, this is the first initial release, and it was Elite. Actually, both of them, all three of them, matter of fact, come to think of it, she was the first one. There might have been another figure during that time, but I can almost guarantee you that she was actually the first women figure to have the double jointed knees. And which one do I like better? Well, I'm gonna tell you this, man, it all depends on what era you're talking about. For example, if you're talking about like WCW back when she was with the NWO, this is gonna be perfect, man. If you want something to kind of have right there side by side with your Hulkster and your Macho Man, this is gonna be best, man. We could put her up on the shoulders, we could celebrate, we can have the time of our lives, and Macho Man will be like, hey, Hulkster, I'm gonna take your girl, man. I don't think so, brother. And then it'll be a WrestleMania match for the ages, and Ms. Elizabeth will be like, please, no, you guys, come on, Hero Fix, get back into the review. You guys get it, you know what I mean, the yellow and the red, that's what she wants to reflect in this. Now, for the arms right here, we are getting some sleeves, which does have the same paint app, same colors as we are seeing on the dress itself. We're getting the all yellow and a little bit of a red accent towards the upper bicep area on both arms right there. Now, for the dress, this is a nice piece, man. The ruffled look to it, this is brilliant, man. Like, this is what I don't understand. Like, we see a ruffled design with this cloth, right? We've seen, like, even, for example, some of the Sting figures, like, they're able to pull this off. Like, I know it's possible, but it's always going back to a budget why they get away from this. And Ms. Elizabeth, it's not like you could use a rubber dress. I mean, you could, but I don't think you would get the same beautiness as we're seeing with this figure. Head scan right here, we're getting a brand new. These were, like, a reused piece. This was the initial, like, startup of the whole thing, and then they just did, like, a different tone on the hair. But these are the exact same head scans, so I'm not going to pull all three of them, but I'll give you, like, the side-by-side on what the old one looks like as opposed to the new one. So for the hair right here, again, this is an 80s look, so you kind of have to work with me, man. The mustache was a thing for the dudes, but for the ladies, they also had a mullet thing going on, especially with that one, man. I don't know what it is about that look, but it's definitely looking very much like a lady mullet. This right here, this is like she took her blow dryer, she started blowing it everywhere, she wanted to prep up for the match. Matter of fact, you know, that's what's going to end up happening. Damn, well, though, we're going to put that blow dryer as well to it, man. I mean, yes, we're not going to be messing around with the hair, but some fix-up, man. Turn on that notification. We got to talk about this. So, dress dress right here, actually the overall figure, even down to the shoes right here, the accuracy on this, I mean, a little bit of a paint flaw right there. I'm going to give her a 9. I feel pretty comfortable with that. For the overall series, you guys, we got to get all of them in here. Coming in at number 1, and this isn't just my choice. This isn't something that I've been putting, like, yes, I'm a huge fan of Bray Wyatt and his new look, but again, this is even going back to ever since this figure has gone up, dude. All the brand new stuff that was put into this figure for first time, right? A brand new mold, the head scan, like the lantern, the accessories. Yeah, we could have utilized a little bit more, but ranking the highest right here from the set, I'm going to give it to this man right here. Number 2, I got to give it to Ravishing Rick Rude. The paint apps on this like tight design, as well as the look, you can't go wrong, man. If you like Ravishing, if you're the man that likes to follow the route, that figgy's going to be it for you. Viscera, number 3, for sure, without a shadow of a doubt. Big Daddy V, my Ministry of Darkness, my corporate Ministry of Darkness, both sections, dude, they've all been fulfilled with this figure. Next up, I'm going to give it to AJ right there, the phenomenal man, a lot of cool stuff. Yes, we got the same scan from the one prior, but the OC, the whole Bullet Club, or the, not Bullet Club Hero Fix, you're talking about NGPW, but the actual like look of the club, this was brought right here, so I'm going to give it to this man. Next, I got to give it to Ms. Elizabeth, great looking figure, man, both like the head scan as well as the dress. What the hell you doing, man? AJ, you always knocking down. That's it. You're going in last place. I'm kidding. I'm not going to do that to him. And then last right here, got to give it to Rhonda, man. Just the way that the head was sitting, you know, we talked about this a little bit too much on the review, but just know that I was a fan of it. But give me your thoughts. Let me know how you guys feel about the wave. What was your figure? What was your favorite figure from this set? What do you guys think that the next figure should be right here for this man? I mean, Firefly Funhouse, that's an option. And we also got the man in the gym. Different possibilities, but the one that they do got to bring up, man, is that next time, got to make sure we get like the little headdress piece, the coat. You know, there's a lot of stuff that could be brought right here for the next release, because that was the biggest thing when I did the review. A lot of people were requesting like, yo, why didn't we get this? Why didn't we get that? Maybe we should get also the Fiend belt. Again, it's just an idea. I want to thank you guys for watching. Be sure to hit the subscribe button if you're new to the channel, and we'll see you on the next one. Phenomenal form on Ronda Rousey. Why you gotta be knocking down my figgies, man?